Members of the crow family, and that includes the jays, the jackdaws, the magpies and ravens, are highly intelligent. And when it comes to their ability to think and to problem solve, we've found that they're as clever as chimpanzees. That's why we call them feathered apes. We've been working with Eurasian jays. They're the ones you often see in your back garden, usually in pairs. They're brightly coloured and they have the most exquisite moustache. We've been studying two behaviours in the Eurasian jays. The first we call caching. This is the ability to hide food, store it, and remember over long periods of time where they've hidden it. What we've discovered about their caching behaviour is that these birds have remarkable, long-lasting memories of where they've stashed or hidden their food. They don't just remember where they've hidden it, they also remember what kinds of foods they've hidden where and how long ago, and even who was watching when they cached or hid the food. What's more, they can even plan ahead, knowing where to stash food for tomorrow's breakfast. That's interesting because the ability to plan ahead has been found in very few species other than humans. In fact, it's only in the jays and chimpanzees. The other behaviour we've been looking at is food sharing, because during the breeding season, the male will feed his female with tasty morsels of the food that she wants. The way in which we conduct our tests is that the male gets the opportunity to watch what his female is eating. And then, once she's full of that food, what he has to do is give her the opposite food. He can only do this if he's watched her. So, to give an analogy, imagine that you've just seen me eat lots of cheese. So, I don't want any more cheese now. So, what you need to do is give me apples instead of cheese. And that's the equivalent to the experiments that we've done with the jays. You often think of jays and other crows as being very raucous, they just have a series of calls, but in fact they have very complex, secretive songs, like a series of whispers, sweet nothings if you like. What we're starting to discover is that the jays are virtuoso mimics, and they incorporate all kinds of interesting sounds into their songs, including human speech. Romero, for example, will sing I love you on a good day.
Hello, Romy. All right, Web. Hello, gorgeous. What's up? What are you doing? What are you doing? Did you get it? What are you doing? Thank you. Would you like some more worms? Yes. Would you like some more? What's up? What's up? Thank you. I'm a good boy. Do you like that one?
So we now know that the jays are highly intelligent. And that's very interesting because it's not just our close relatives, our primate cousins that are intelligent. It's these very distantly related birds with whom we shared a common ancestor over 300 million years ago. It's interesting to know exactly what the similarities and differences between our minds and those alien minds are. And that's one of the things we're interested in investigating further. Of course, to do so, we need detailed observations and very carefully planned problem-solving tasks in order to find out what exactly the birds are thinking and how they solve problems. So next time you see the jays in your garden, think of them as the feathered apes on your bird table. Perhaps you can do some careful observations too, to see whether or not they'll cache and they'll share food with their partner, and also whether they engage in this vocal frolicking.